Welcome back to PJ Chain Design. Today we are going to look into this intertwined style of pendant. Are you ready? Let's get started. Before we start it, remind you to join the membership program. The join button is on the right button of this video next to the subscribe. It has a lot of extra content for the member only, and it's also support my passion to help many people to learn jewelry design and providing free video here for you. I'm going to starting at the front view, bringing the stone for about 5 millimeter, and we are planning to do a prong set. So I'm going to draw a line roughly about this. You do want it to have your prong longer than the table. It really depends on you are using for the rendering or you are using for the 3D printing. For the 3D printing, you definitely want to have this a little bit longer. So in my demonstration here, I'm using for the rendering, so I want to make it a little bit shorter, most likely when they finish. First things we wanted to do is we want to pipe this guy. I want to make sure that the pipe that I have, after piping, I'm moving my prong in a little bit. You don't want to cut more than 25% of the prong thickness. You can make it bigger if you feel like this is too thin there, but just make sure that it's not cutting more than 25%. After that, deciding how many prongs that you need to have, you can have polar array and starting from the center as a zero. Number of the piece you want to copy is 4, and we want to do 360 degree, so we get something like that. That would be your prong. And then the second thing we wanted to do is we need to create a bezel underneath it. So let me draw a curve, a square, almost like this one, and I'm going to change to this color in blue. And then so I'm going to tilt it a little bit. You do not want this square to be over the stone size. From the front view, you won't see the metal behind it. Let's go ahead to using the surface tool. We want to use a revolve and set it as a center as a zero, and we wanted to do 360 degree, and that's how we get the cup underneath it. I might want to move it down a little bit more for look like when it's done by the rendering. Alright, so let's go ahead to bowling unit, those 4 pieces, and let's go ahead to draw another box right there, and roughly we want to move it to where past the coulette. And then we can do Boolean difference, this one out of this one. So that's how we get the middle piece. Now let's go ahead to do the intertwine pattern behind it. So we have this stone, it's about 5 millimeter with the prong set. I'm going to starting with the circle at the front view. And you want to get it as close as possible. It really depends on the thickness in the back of that design. And we simply wanted to use that and as the reference. Then we are coming into the curve tool. You have this one that's called helix. And for the helix, if you are just not choosing anything in the option, all you get is this spring looking things. But we want to actually do additional things with this helix option. So let's go to the helix, and then we choose around a curve. It's going to ask you which curve you want to pick, and I want to pick up this one. Now in my design, I have them going around for 6 turns. You can set it for 3, 4, 5, 6, whatever that your design is going to look like. I'm going to stick with 6. So let me turn this curve into the red color. Once you see this, you're going to see this curve on the red color is actually wrapping around to the purple color, and that's what we exactly looking for. Let's do a test. We are going to pick up this red color, and we are going to use the pipe command. And simply just giving roughly about diameter in 1 millimeter and take a look on how it look. All right. And it's cutting the prong a little bit. That's all right, because we are going to move it down later on. And just take a look on if that is the size you wanted to have. If not, you may want to make it bigger or make it smaller size on your pipe. The next step we wanted to do is we need to make a copy. So let me just using Control C and Control V to paste in there. So now we have two shape in there. All the peak right here in between the peak is about 60 degree. What I did is 360 divided by 6, so I got 60 degree there. So in between that will be 30 degrees. So what I wanted to do is pick up the surface and using the gumball to turning 30 degree, and so you will get this intertwined design over there. Let's move it down a little bit and make sure that they are touching. If they are not, you might want to scale it down, because if they are not touching or they just barely touch, you might not have a good casting. You can do 1D scale to make it up a little bit like this, so that will fit it better. And after that, all you need to have is to creating a jump ring, and that can hook on the bail that you are designed for. If you are interested in stone setting 3D model, don't forget to check out the playlist for a bunch of a video on the stone setting and my course for stone setting with the Rhino. I hope you enjoyed today's video. See you next.